Hello! Today you will learn how to decompile maps in the source engine. So, first off, we've got to find the map we want to decompile. So, I'm going to right-click on Half-Life 2, go into Properties, set Launch Options, and then type dash console. This will give us a developer console in the game. So, let's start the game here now. You see we have our console here. So, the first thing I'm going to do here is just load a game. And then I press escape again to bring up the console again, and we have a bunch of output here. I'm looking for a loading game, there yes, spawn server D1_trainstation_01, that is the name of the map we're on now. So if you type map in the console, you will see all the maps there are there. You can just select one of the maps and load it up and see if it's the one you want. So let's decompile D1_trainstation_01. Now we need to get a program that can get the maps for us because they're hidden in GCF files. So we're going to use GCFScape for this. I'm going to download the archive. There is a 64-bit and a 32-bit version. I'm going to use the 32-bit version here. So just open up your Steam folder and then go to Steam Apps. Here you have all the GCF files, as you can see. So I'm just going to extract the contents of the x86 folder into here. Now you just launch a GCFScape. Also, keep in mind, if Steam is open, you might want to close that because that might block loading of the GCF files. Press the open button. And I think the maps I'm looking for is in the Half-Life 2 content.gcf. So I'm going to open that up. And here we have the contents of that. Now we just go to the HL2 folder and maps, and in here we have all the maps. So I'm just going to create a folder on the desktop and name that decompiler. And then I'm going to extract this map here by quite simply pulling it into the folder, and there it's done. Now that we have our map, we want a program that can decompile the map. And for that we are going to use VMEX, standing for Valve Map Extractor. So I'll open up my browser here, and I'll type in VMEX in Google and search for that. Just get the first link there. So let's just go to the official site. Here you can read a bit about VMEX, and down there it says download and installation instructions here. VMEX is a Java application that requires Sun's Java runtime environment. So download Java from that link there. So just scroll down here until you get to Java Runtime Environment 5.0 Update 22. Press the download button. And select your platform. I agree to those terms, whatever they might be. I'm going to get the offline installation. And then just open that installer up. I'm just going to go with the default settings. So after that has been downloaded and installed, we're going to download VMEX also. And then open up that zip file. Here we have a bunch of files. You might want to read the readme, and the files we need are vmex.bat and vmex.jar. So I'm going to throw them into the decompile folder. And then let's try to run this here. Nothing happened, so open up the bat file in your favorite text editor. And well, it all looks fine. I'm just going to put a pause here at the end to see what it says. Oh, Java is not recognized in internal external, blah, blah, blah. Okay, it seems that the environment variable is not recognized. The command Java is not bound to a program. So instead of writing Java there, we have to write the path to the program manually. We could set up an environment variable, but that didn't work for me, so I'm going to do it like this instead. So if you install Java at its default location, it's going to be in program files, Java, and then GRE, and then bin, and down there you have java.exe. So just copy this path here, put in a quotation mark, and put the path in there, and then type in java.exe. So now we have the path to the actual program instead of an alias. I guess this should work now, so let's try it. Yeah, it works fine. Now we just need to load the BSP and then push decompile. You can change the settings there if you want to. They should be self-explanatory. Now we got a VMF file there that can be loaded into Hammer, so I'm just going to do that to finish this up. Engine version, source engine 2006, because I'm starting Half-Life 2 Hammer editor here. File. So let's just open the VMF file up. Mine is on the desktop in the decompile folder. And here we have the map. So these are incredibly useful tools when learning Hammer, since you can just open up one of Valve's map and take a look at how they do their things, because since they made the game and the engine, they hopefully know how to best use it. If you feel like you've learned something from this tutorial and want to help me out, you can do that by favoriting it and giving me a thumbs up. If you have any comments or questions, I'll be more than happy to answer them in the comments below. You can also send me a PM if you have any questions or any tutorial requests. So, thanks a lot for watching, and I hope you have a great day!